Hey everyone, this is Matt Perez, and today we're going to get started on a new series on DriveWorksXpress. Now, we've already covered some of the basics in a few intro videos that I did. We talked about basic setup of parts and naming dimensions, setting up a database for DriveWorksXpress, bringing your parts in, capturing dimensions, switching configurations, making your basic forms, and basic sets of rules. With this video series, we're going to be dealing with a multi-body part that has several configurations. We're going to be dealing with a single outlet and dual outlet. We're going to allow the user to change a few properties. They're going to be able to select the inlet and outlet diameters, whether or not it's a single or a dual outlet. We're going to let them determine the shape of the muffler, if it's going to be oval like you see on the screen, or if they want a round muffler. And then we're also going to try to drive the material in appearance. So it's very important to note that there are three versions of DriveWorks. There's a DriveWorksXpress that comes with every seat of SolidWorks. Then there's going to be a DriveWorks Solo and a DriveWorks Professional version. Now, each version obviously can do more. Now, when you're dealing with DriveWorks Solo, you have a lot more control over things like materials, the color of your parts, and even the textures. When you're dealing with DriveWorksXpress, we're a little bit more limited. So we're going to be dealing with creating multiple configurations of each. We're going to be allowing the user to select between an aluminized steel, a stainless steel, and just a mild steel. So that means each version, each configuration is going to have three configurations based on it. So that means we're going to have a total of six configurations just to be able to select between the dual or single outlet and the different materials. So I'm going to show you guys how to handle that with our sets of rules and doing nested if statements. So that's probably the most complicated topic that we're going to deal with. We're also going to talk about bringing drawings in and how to link your drawings together. To get started, we need to make sure that this model is set up and ready to go. Now, obviously, we don't have multiple configurations yet for the materials. So the first thing we want to do is we want to deal with that. Now you'll notice at the bottom I have display states, and I've selected the checkbox that says link display states to configuration. Now we can very easily modify the material of each configuration by selecting the material and changing it. But we not only want to change the material, we want to change the appearance as well. So it's very important that we use display states and that we link them to our configurations. So first I have my dual outlet configuration. I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to add a derived configuration. And again, with DriveWorks, it's very important that we know the names of our configurations and that we're very careful with these. So I'm going to say dual outlet. In this case, I'm just going to say AL for my aluminized muffler. And then again, I'm going to add a derived configuration. I'm going to say dual outlet. And in this case, I'm going to say SS for stainless steel. And lastly, I'm going to add another one that says dual outlet. And in this case, it's just going to be steel. We need to do the same thing with the single outlet. Now, when we approach this in DriveWorks, I'm going to handle this in two different ways. First, we're only going to deal with one set of types of parts. We're only going to deal with either a single outlet or dual outlet. That way, we only have three different choices. So the user can select dual outlet, and then we can select between three of the sub configurations. That makes it a single nested if statement. We'll get into that a little bit in the rules section, but we need to make sure that we understand that we need to grab these configurations inside DriveWorks. So we got single outlet AL. We're going to add another drive configuration for single outlet SS. And lastly, we're going to add single outlet steel. So now that we have all these configurations added, we need to go in and modify the display state and any material properties. All right, so now that I have the material selected for my single outlet steel, I can go to my dual outlet and I can modify that as well. So again, satin finish stainless steel will be the standard for my basic steel parts. Now I want to take care of the stainless steel version. I'm going to go to my appearance section. I'm going to go down to chrome. I'm going to do chrome plated. So next I want to go to my single outlet stainless steel, modify the appearance again, go to chrome and do a chrome plate. Next I'm going to be going to my AL. Now I don't have an aluminized steel material, but I'm going to come in here to my steel and I'm going to do a brushed steel. And I want to do the same thing for my dual outlet, go into my material, change the appearance, and do a brushed steel. Now that we've modified the appearance of all these, we can go back through the configurations and make sure that all of these change as needed. So everything seems to be updating properly. The next thing we need to do is configure the material. So you can see that alloy material is already selected. If we right click, we can configure material, and we can change all of them as needed. So my dual outlet aluminized steel, I'm gonna come in here, I'm gonna browse, and in this case, I'm actually gonna use a galvanized steel. So that's gonna be fairly close to the aluminized. Now you'll notice when I do that, it changes the appearance of it. Now, because I have it linked to the display states, if I come back in and select another configuration, you can see that it changes. Now, if you only want to drive the appearance, you simply use the configurations and the display state. If you also want to drive the materials, you need to modify those with the configurations as well. So I just wanted to show you that you can change not only the materials, but also the appearances and use them as needed. So now that we have all this information, let's go ahead and go to DriveWorks and set up a new database. So we're going to create a database, and we're going to just call this database muffler. And now we can add a material or a part or an assembly or whatever we need to into our DriveWorks database. I'm going to use the current open part, and you can see that now it's calling the oval muffler as our captured part or a captured model. So we can go and select our dimensions and features that we wish to modify. Now, the first thing that we need to determine is what we want the user to change. Now, we know we want to give them the option to change from a round or an oval muffler. In order to do that, we're going to need access to this vertical dimension here, the oval height. So I want to capture the oval height dimension. Let's go ahead and pin this open and add our oval height dimension. The next thing we need to capture is the inlet and outlet diameters. So I'm going to go to my inlet opening, and I want to capture the inlet diameter and add that. Next, I need to go to my outlet opening, and I need to add the outlet diameter. So these allow the user to modify the oval height, which we're not going to give the user direct access to the oval height, but instead we're going to use it in a set of rules that determine whether or not the oval height is going to be equal to the oval width. Now, we should make a quick note that the oval width is 14 inches. So when the user selects a round muffler, we're going to make this value oval height equal to 14 inches. Otherwise, it'll be equal to 6 inches. So in our set of values, we have our dimensions for oval height, inlet diameter, and outlet diameter. Anything else that we need the user to be able to select, we can create in our form. So all the dimensions are set. We don't have to determine any other dimensions for the user, so we can get started on going a little bit further. So now we want to go to our custom properties and make sure that we don't have any custom properties that we need to add. If you were dealing with DriveWorks solo, you can create a custom property called DW material, and that would allow you to drive the material as a custom property within SolidWorks. Now, unfortunately, DriveWorks Express doesn't have that functionality, so we have to control it with configurations. Next, we want to go to the drawing and configuration section. We need to select yes, allow me to create a rule to switch configurations. And we also want to browse and capture any drawings that are based on our design. Now that we've captured all this data, we can go ahead and start creating a form. This is going to end the first video, but stick with us as we create a form and we get a little bit more in depth into some of these complex rules that we need. As always, if you guys have any questions, please email SolidWorks support at mlc-cad.com, and we'll see you next time.